And we're keeping you ahead on all the details that are coming in on the hectic meetings in the national capital for the cabinet formation. Sources telling India Today now that two leaders each from the JDU and also the Shiv Sena will get a ministerial board in the Modi Sarkar 2.0. One leader each from Akali Dal and Apna Dal will also be accommodated and be given a ministerial berth. Sources say that Anupriya Patel from Apna Dal could be selected and be a part of this cabinet. Paulami is joining us with more details on this. Paulami, one meeting after another with Amit Shah. Several of these NDA ally leaders have been meeting with him. There's no doubt that they're all going to try and, you know, get their slice of the pie. But what are you hearing on the cabinet allocations as far as the allies themselves are concerned?
Well, Akshata, as we speak, the final touches are being given to ministers list, which will, of course, be the members of parliament who will be sworn in tomorrow at Rashtrapati Bhavan. Amit Shah, after that meeting with Nitish Kumar, left his residence and he's reached 7 LKM, the Prime Minister's residence right now where we're standing. And obviously, he will be going through that list again with the Prime Minister because he is the one who's, Mr. Shah is the one who's doing all the negotiations, all the talking with all the allies. And after that conversation with Nitish Kumar, he's now finalizing that list with the Prime Minister, apprising him about his conversation with Mr. Nitish Kumar, obviously. And they're going through that final list. As far as the JDU is concerned, what we've heard is that the JDU...
Yes, follow me. Yes, Paulami, that's the breaking news that we're also tracking right now of BJP President Amit Shah. He's reached the Prime Minister's residence again. Yesterday, Prime Minister Modi and Amit Shah held a five-hour-long meeting to discuss cabinet formation. Those visuals on your screens right there is of Amit Shah's convoy, his vehicle also making its way to the Prime Minister's residence in Lok Kalyan Marg. And Paulami, it's possibly now that there will be some sort of finalizing of the names as far as the cabinet is goes. We lost that connection with Paulami. She's been keeping us ahead on all the developments taking place in the national capital. Right now, as we speak, Prime Minister Modi and Amit Shah are in a huddle. They met last evening as well, and that meeting lasted for nearly 4.5 hours to 5 hours. Today, now, Amit Shah is back at the Prime Minister's residence after holding a series of meetings himself at the party headquarters. Amit Shah also met with several alliance allies with the likes of Nitish Kumar as well. And even as we're giving you details of which allies are going to be accommodated in the cabinet, the final touches are being made as we speak in that meeting that's taking place at 7 Lok Kalyan Marg at the Prime Minister's residence. Amit Shah is currently there, possibly communicating what are the decisions that he's been made, what are the highlights of the meetings that he's had with several of these allies, the likes of Nitish Kumar. Remember, the JDU is going to be accommodated in this cabinet, is what we hear, besides the Shiv Sena, the Akali Dal and the Apne Dal. We'll have to see if that changes, if that kind of a formula really changes after this meeting. But remember, last evening as well, there was a blueprint of sorts drawn out as far as the cabinet formation goes between Prime Minister Modi and Amit Shah. It was a meeting that lasted nearly 5 hours. And now you're going to be seeing yet another meeting between Amit Shah and Prime Minister Modi where they're possibly finalizing their names. This also comes after Arun Jaitley has gone public with his announcement that he is not going to be a part of the cabinet. So one of the big decisions that everyone will be watching out for is who is going to be the next finance minister. But on your screens right now are the details also of the allies who are going to be accommodated in the cabinet. All these details only on India Today about the likes of JDU, Shiv Sena, Akali Dal and Apna Dal figuring in this cabinet. Paulami Saha is back with us. Paulami, another meeting there between Prime Minister Modi and Amit Shah. As you told us earlier, this is possibly to really churn out all the finer details of the cabinet.
That's right, Akshata. Right behind me at the 7 Lok Kalyan Marg residence of the Prime Minister, Amit Shah and the Prime Minister are meeting right now to finalize and chalk out the details of who will feature in that Union Council of Ministers list, which will be sworn in at the Rashtrapati Bhavan tomorrow at 7 p.m. So those final details, that fine-tuning is happening right behind me. Now, Amit Shah is the liaison person as far as the BJP is concerned, who is having all the conversations because he's been the main strategist he's been the one to have constantly had conversations with all allies throughout the election campaign, in the run-up to the election campaign, and now as well to understand where they stand, what their expectations from the Bharatiya Janata Party are, and eventually talking that out with the Prime Minister as to what exactly the BJP can offer its allies. So after that meeting that he had at his residence with the Bihar Chief Minister, he's now at the 7 Lok Kalyan Marg residence of the Prime Minister going through those details. It's likely that he will go back again to his residence. There could be some more meetings as well. And only by the end of today will calls start going out.
Paulami, give us the breakdown that you're hearing so far about which are the allies that are going to be accommodated in the cabinet. We're being told the JDU as well as Shiv Sena could have a number of representatives really in the cabinet.
Well, obviously, they will be accommodating the allies who've been part of the Union Council of Ministers previously, who've been steady allies of the Bharatiya Janata Party in the NDA, which includes, of course, the Shiv Sena, which includes the Akali Dal, which includes the Apna Dal as well. But, of course, there will be new allies as well who have forged agreements with the Bharatiya Janata Party in the run-up to 2019, which includes the JDU. So the JDU will feature in the Union Council of Ministers for the first time. What we're learning is that two members of parliament from the JDU could be sworn in. Now, in Bihar, the BJP-JDU alliance had a spectacular victory. It was not suspected or anticipated that they would have a victory of this scale, given that the Gathbandhan was taking them on. The RJD Congress Gathbandhan was taking them on, but clearly that did not have its impact on the ground. So the JDU-BJP came out triumphant in that contest. So JDU is going to feature prominently in the new Union Council of Ministers. Again, states which have paid good dividends to the Bharatiya Janata Party. West Bengal, Odisha, again, these are states that they're eyeing for the future in terms of the upcoming assembly elections in the state of West Bengal, for instance, in 2021. So they want to reward these states. Now, two union ministers from the state of Odisha already in the previous Union Council of Ministers, Dharmendra Pradhan and Jawalaram. There's a possibility that they could raise that number by one or so, or they could just stick with two Union Council of Ministers. That remains to be seen. Dharmendra Pradhan is a sure shot. He is going to feature in the Union Council of Ministers, because the fact is, as far as building the BJP's organization on the ground in Odisha from scratch is concerned, the credit has gone to Dharmendra Pradhan. So he will be rewarded for the same. West Bengal, they had two members of parliament the last time round in 2014. Babul Supriyo, one from Asansol, SS Aluwalia, one from Darjeeling. But this time round, they won again. They might feature again in the Union Council of Ministers, but this time there are 18 members of parliament as opposed to two for the Bharatiya Janata Party from the state of West Bengal. So presume that there will be new ministers who could come in from the state of West Bengal. One of the names that's doing the round is that of Lokit Chatterjee, who won from Ghatal in West Bengal, a very vocal, feisty BJP spokesperson, young woman, and the Prime Minister is focusing on youth this time as well. So Lokit Chatterjee might find her introduction into the Union Council of Ministers the first time she becomes an MP itself. So that is expected. As far as the Northeast is concerned, again, since 2014, the BJP's footprint in the Northeast has only grown rapidly. And this time again, the Northeast as a bloc voted in support of the NDA. So the Northeast is going to feature majorly in the Union Council of Ministers. Earlier, there were only two ministers from the Northeast, which included Kiran Rijiju from Arunachal Pradesh. And then, of course, there was Rajan Goyen from Assam. There could be more coming from the Northeast part of the country. Again, they did not get much from the southern part of the country in terms of the people voting in their favor. But they will try to reward the South as well and try to woo the voters of the South by giving them more representation. Earlier, it was only from the state of Karnataka that you saw Sadanand Gowda represent the state of Karnataka and Anant Hegde. There is a possibility Prahlad Joshi, again, who has been a member of parliament for some time now, could be given a position in the Union Council of Ministers. There was only Pon Radhakrishnan from the state of Tamil Nadu the last time round. Again, they could be looking at a possibility of looking at some representation from the state of Tamil Nadu, they've not done very well. They haven't had any footprint in Kerala, so they cannot bring in anyone. But Telangana, again, could be rewarded. 4 members of parliament for BJP from there.
So many factors to be kept in mind by BJP President Amit Shah and Modi. Very interesting to see exactly what the cabinet composition will be like. Leaders to keep in mind from the northeast, from Bengal, Karnataka, Odisha, states where the BJP has done exceptionally well, and also to ensure that they accommodate allies who've performed well for the NDA. Paulami, thanks for joining us with all those details and breaking down really what the thinking is as far as the cabinet formation goes.
Thanks for watching the video. For more such news and updates, please like, share and subscribe to India Today. Also check out our other great videos from our channel. We know you will love to.